Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another Ramadan therapy. Allahumma laka alhamd. We're in the final 10 days of the month of Ramadan, and this is dua number 28. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our month of Ramadan a month of healing, prosperity, and happiness, and correction to that which is ailing us in our life, drawing us closer and closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-qurba ya rabbal alameen. We ask you to draw us closer towards you with an increase in our sujood. Allahumma ameen. This dua is comprised of four important words. Allahu Akbar. Dua of just four words? Yes. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. But it is a dua that was heard by the Prophet, made by the Prophet ﷺ, and heard by the companions of the Messenger of Allah, that he would habitually say it. And it is something that he would say in his salah. There's narrations of it. And after salah, it would be something he would say when he would be moving about. And it would be something he would say when he was seated or reclining in the company of others. So it's one of those multi-purpose dua, and you'll see why. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked for four things, four particular words. He asks for guidance, he asks for righteousness, piety, he asks for chastity, and he asks for affluence sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Each of those are four things that you and I esteem and want in life. They are the basis of all of the relationships that we have in life, as you will soon see. So what is this dua of the Prophet ﷺ? And I hope, inshallah, that you can memorize it throughout the course of this discussion. You'll find the link to it in the description of my YouTube page. Inshallah, you can subscribe as well. Allahumma, O my Lord, O Allah, you're the only one I turn to in worship. And that's what the word Allahumma. You alone, Allah, do I make this request, this petition to, this invocation of, this supplication seeking. Allahumma inni, I ask of this. As'aluka, I request of you. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda. MashaAllah. Oh Allah, I beg of you, I ask of you, I supplicate and I invoke you to bless me with al-huda, guidance. Guidance in all of its qualities. Now there's two levels of guidance. There's the guidance of seeing, of basira, where you see guidance so it inspires you. You read a book, you read a hadith, you heard this discussion or others that move your heart to action. So there's this guidance of Allah showing you the way in a practical and real sense. But there's a second guidance, which is an esoteric internal guidance, which is the guidance of your heart being moved by Allah. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the governor of the hearts. يُقَلِّبُهَا كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. Allah alternates the hearts as He sees fit, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala determines in His decree. So when you're asking for hidayah, make sure in your intention you're asking for both. Oh Allah, let somebody lead me to that which is good. Oh Allah, let me find the truth. Oh Allah, let me read of it, hear of it, witness it. Let me be a person who recognizes the ayat that you have sent. Sanurihim ayatina. Allah says, I will show them my signs. Oh Allah, open my eyes to these signs. But number two, make your intention that the hidayah you're asking for, the huda you're asking for, is that your heart opens. Sharahallah. That's what Musa asked for. Rabbi shrahli sadri. And that's what the Prophet was given. Alam nashrah laka sadrak. Haven't I prepared your heart to receive the truth? Allahumma shrah sudurana. Awaman kana mayitan fa ahyaynah. Waja'alna fi qalb. Waja'alna lahu nura. The one who was, dead to the spirit of faith. And we gave them life. We put in their heart light. This is the second level of hidayah. It's inspired by Allah, where Allah casts into the heart a sense of softness that opens it to accept the truth that it sees with its eyes and hears with its ears. May Allah give us the both levels of guidance. Allahumma ameen. Sadly, there are many who will see guidance with their eyes, but their hearts will not recognize it. And Allah warns of this in the Quran. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. It's not that the eyes are blind and they can't see the reality, but the chest contains a heart that has no perception and is dim to the truth. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda. Oh Allah, I ask you for this guidance, the two levels of guidance. Wattuqa, and oh Allah, bless me with taqwa. Wattuqa. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wattuqa. Oh Allah, bless me with guidance and also piety. Piety is the thing you need to discover guidance. And Allah tells us this in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This book is a guidance to those who possess piety. And therefore, to receive that piety that we're asking for, to Allah open our heart, to show us the truth that we can follow it and practice it, It requires a sincerity of heart and a piety of purpose and being in the soul. At-taqwa ha-huna, your piety is internal. We ask Allah to make the tasfiyah of our qulub, and that was one of the dua we learned 2 or 3 days ago. May Allah accept it and you can return to it. Maybe dua number 23 or 24. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa, piety, O Allah. Piety is not just a feeling in the heart. Iman, which is in the heart, ليس الإيمان بالتمني ولا بالتحلي ولكن الإيمان ما وقر في القلب وصدقه العمل. Iman is not what, you know, one hopes for. It is what takes residence in the heart and is proven through deeds. It's actions you perform. And therefore Iman, the purpose of Iman and Taqwa, which are interchangeable. At-Tuqa means faith in Allah, and that faith is in your heart, but it must be proven through deeds. So here Allah, the Prophet is asking, oh Allah, show me guidance, which is what I will believe in my heart, and give me taqwa, which is the actions of the body. Whenever taqwa is referred to in the Quran and the tradition, it means deeds, not just belief in the heart. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afaf. Oh Allah, grant me chastity. May Allah grant us and our families and our homes and our children and our offspring chastity. A sense of iffah. Iffah to nafs. There's a chastity of the soul where you don't seek what other people have. You're not a jealous person. You're not a greedy person. You're a person who's content with what Allah has given. You aspire to greatness, but if you don't achieve it because it is sinful to achieve it in the way that others have, then you're happy to be where you are, because that is better, what is better for you for your dunya and akhirah. Iffah to nafs is that you don't seek an excessiveness, that you have an ability to say, qana'a, I have enough and Allah has blessed me with much and I'm thankful for it. To be a person of afaf is that you are able to control your bodily organs, in particular, the three most important: the eyes, the tongue, and the private parts. That you're able to control your sexual desires, you're able to control your verbal impulses, and you're able to cast away your eyes from that which is sinful. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afaf wal-ghina, and oh Allah, enrich us. The Prophet ﷺ says, al-ghina ghina al-nufus, ghina al-nafs. True affluence is that your soul can find contentment. It's internal. And therefore to be affluent is a blessed thing. That Allah gives you from the different kinds of worldly material is a blessed thing. We should all aspire, inshallah, to be multimillionaires, not just millionaires. May Allah bless us all with a vastness of rizq that we earn from halal. These are the two conditions. Earn in halal and spend in halal, and give of its share in zakah as it is due. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us affluence, but recognize that the greatest affluence is the enrichment of the soul, that a person is able to be content. And therefore you see, al-afaf wal-ghina. Oh Allah, give me chastity, and oh Allah, enrich me. Allahumma ameen. May Allah give us this affluent enrichment where we recognize a place with Allah. Don't ever feel shy about craving your share from the dunya and working hard and saving well and being economically empowered. Those are all things that are from the sunnah of the Prophet and the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim. The hand that gives is better than the hand that receives. The one who shares is better than the one who is shared with. The one who is strong in mind, in heart, in iman, in economic prosperity is more beloved to Allah than the one who is poor and weak. All of these are from the tradition and the authentic words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We make this dua to Allah. 4 words. Allahumma inni as'aluka. O Allah, I ask you. At-huda wa-tuqa wal-afafa wal-ghina. O Allah, bless us and give us guidance, piety, chastity, and affluence. Allahumma ameen. This is your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another Ramadan therapy. The month of dua, may Allah accept it from us. This was dua number 28. May Allah bless us with a great ending to the month of Ramadan, that we end stronger in our worship and love for Allah than we began this blessed month. Allahumma ameen. La'allakum tattaqoon. Perhaps you will attain a greater sense of consciousness.